So sine wave generation. So they, you know, say are you know, in any waveform generation. So how to generate the waveform? Okay. Waveforms. So that is the task, waveform. So just to, you know, have some complexity. Okay. So what I'll do, I will consider, you know, sine wave first. Okay. So sine wave. So how to generate sine wave? So this is what I'm considering now. So now, in a microcontroller level, how you can generate sine wave? So you know, sine wave will look like this, right? So you know the sine wave. So sine wave will look like this, sinusoidal signal. Now, how can you generate this sine wave using microcontroller? Can anybody iterate on this? How I can generate sine wave using microcontroller? So can anybody tell how we can generate a sine wave using microcontroller? Yeah, anybody can come in and you can tell how we can generate sine wave. Some kind of architecture. So what logic we have to follow to generate the sine wave using microcontroller? Gunashekar, can you come in and tell me how we can generate sine wave using microcontroller? Gunashekar, you're not there? Okay. So now I'll tell you how to generate a sine wave using a microcontroller. So for that, what circuit I will consider? I'll consider like this. Okay, so this is say your microcontroller. Okay, so this is your microcontroller, and here you can know you have a I/O port. I mean input output port you have. So you can use any one port, say port naught, port zero. You are using. Okay, it is a sine wave generation means output, right? So this is always output. So you are outputting that particular digital value to analog to digital converter. Okay, so you are using analog to digital converter. So sorry, digital to analog converter, so DAC, and here this that particular signal comes. Okay, so now after this, what happens? Let us see. See here, you know this port zero. Okay, so what is the port zero? Port zero. Port zero can vary from 00 to FF, correct? So port minimum value can be 00. And maximum value can be FF. So that means what is the output? Output in the output of this particular DAC. So now I'll consider this as, you know, okay, A. Okay, so I am considering that as, you know, A. So what is A? A, it can be, you know, you can map that A to 00 means 0 volts. Okay, FF means you can map that FF to 5 volts. You understood? So you can map the hexadecimal number with the voltage. With the voltage. Now, what you can see here. So now the thing is, the minimum value of the, you know, output is zero, and maximum value is 5 volts. So that means if you plot, if you write a first quadrant space. Then what happens? The minimum value is zero. Okay, so this is the minimum value, so zero, and the maximum value, okay, somewhere 5 volts. So this is 5 volts, and this is 0 volts. So and what is the output? Output always, you know, your output values always lies inside this. So here you can set any value you can create in this particular space, in between 0 to 5 volts. So that is the freedom you have. Now say for example I need to create a sine wave. Okay, so 0 to 5 volts only. Now what I can set this particular hexadecimal number in port 0, so that I can follow some lookup table. Okay, what is that lookup table? So I'll use this kind of lookup table. What is that lookup table? Time versus the magnitude value. Okay, what is that time versus magnitude value? I'll just follow. So this is time and this is basically the magnitude value. Okay, so this is magnitude value at time 0. Okay, so what is the magnitude value? Now here to know this particular things, what you have to do. So first, this is basically time is 0. Okay, so what is magnitude value? Magnitude value is sine omega t, correct? Time omega t. So now what is that sine omega t? Sine, okay, 2 pi f into t. Okay, so in that sense, what you are substituting? You are substituting, so t is equal to 0 and you will get sine 0. Okay, so that is sine 0 is equal to 0. Okay, now one more step you have to do here. So this 0, whatever the sine value you get, so that you need to convert to hexadecimal number. Okay, so that means time 0, hexadecimal value is 0. Got it? Time 0, hexadecimal value is 0. Similarly, you have to take n number of samples, time samples, say, minimum. Say how many values you have to take. So 100, say 100 sample you have to take in 20 millisecond. Okay, so divided by 100, so this many samples in 20 millisecond you have to take 100 samples. So now what is your incremental time? Incremental time is basically 1 pi. Okay, so 0.2 millisecond, correct? 0.2 millisecond is the time. So what does it mean? The next time will be 0.2, you see? So 0.2 milli, that to 0.2 millisecond. Now then what you have to do, again you have to do the same work. So sine, okay, so sine omega t only you have to calculate. What is that sine omega t? So sine 314. Into 0.2 milli, 10 to the power of minus 3. So this particular part, okay, so this particular part you need to solve. Okay, so you will get some number. Okay, so maybe just a second. Hello. You see, there is one problem. Okay, so now the thing is, say for example sine some value you may get something like 0.9. okay, so some unit value if you get, what you have to do? So in that particular sense, what we have to do, so your sine value may swing from 0 to 1. So then you just have to proper scaling value, you can multiply that with FF. Okay, so FF in the sense 256. Okay, so when you multiply 256, whatever value you get, so you will get reasonable number, and it will definitely result in a proper hexadecimal number. Now in this particular case, I am just considering 0.9. Okay, so 0.9 into 256. Okay, so I am just taking 0.9 into 256, some value I am just considering. So that is 230. So then what we have to do, we have to convert that particular number to different number system. So what is that 230? 230 in hexadecimal, it is E6. So now if you get 0.9, then you have to write E6. So like that, so you just have to give different time. Okay, next time will be 0.4. Okay, 0.4 millisecond. Okay, so 0.6 millisecond. Like that, it will go up to 20 millisecond. You understood? So for each value, you need to calculate this particular hexadecimal number. You understood? That is most important. So you need to substitute the time value, and you have to evolve this particular, you know, hexadecimal number. And what is the idea? Idea is that, so these values will, you know, replicate sinusoidal waveform. So when you convert this values to analog quantity, and when you give it in some pins, then it will, you know, produce sinusoidal waveform. You understood? Because we are calculated the sinusoidal and we are creating this particular lookup table. This lookup table is basically sinusoidal lookup table. You know, analog quantities we can't generate. If you have some kind of oscillator kind of things, then you can generate the sinusoidal signal. But in digital platforms like microcontroller or microprocessor, it is impossible to generate continuous signal. So this is how they will do. So they will have a lookup table. Using that particular lookup table, they will generate the waveforms. Okay, they will generate the waveforms. Now, like this, you created say 0.1, so 0.1, okay, 0.4, okay, so like this, so some E6, okay, final value, so here, 20 millisecond, right? So 20 millisecond means how you will get the values. The values will be again in the first quadrant. So this value varies from 0 to FF. Okay, can you see here 0 to FF? Okay, what kind of lookup table you have to create? You have to create a lookup table like this. So for this waveform, you need to create a lookup table. Okay, so when you get a 0, 0, then for every value you need to add 7F. Okay, so that, you know, always your waveform will shift above. Okay, 7F. So it is actual hexadecimal number. Okay, hexadecimal number will be 7F. First value will be 7F. Like that, next value will be some incremental 7F, 80, something like that. It increases. Now you can see here, this is 7F. Okay, first value is 7F. Like that, it increases. So you are taking a lot of discrete value, and the peak value is FF. Somewhere you will get FF value. So FF value you will get, and again decreases, and again it comes to 7F, and you see again it decreases, and it goes up to 0, 0. Again it will come, and it will come to 7F. So this is how hexadecimal number varies to generate the sine wave. So we need this particular lookup table. So to get this particular table. Now you can see here. Now when I flush these values continuously in this particular circuit, what happens? You will get a sine wave here. Got it? Not the elevated, the clamped waveform. Okay, so not this one. Okay, so you will get the clamped waveform. What kind of waveform you will get? You will get so this waveform you will get it. You understood? So now one more issue is there. What is that issue? I don't want clamped waveform. I just want to get a proper symmetrical sine wave. In that sense, I just have to bring this waveform down. So for that, you already studied clamp in electronic circuits and linear ICs. You have already studied clippers, clampers, and all. You can use only diode to clamp the circuit. Positive clampers, negative clampers, all those things are there. Okay, so using op amp also, you can create positive clamper and negative clampers. So now in this particular case, I have to shift the waveforms down, correct? I just have to shift the waveforms down. So for that, I'll use negative clamper. Okay, so then if I use negative clamper, I'll just show you the circuit. Okay, so maybe this. Yeah, so this is basically a negative clamper. Okay, so negative clamper. So if I write that particular circuit, okay, so cascade to this. So now how that circuit will look like, and you will be having some kind of op amp. Okay. Okay, so some kind of op amp you can write. So this circuit, okay, so you can write this circuit. What basically this particular does, this is very important. Okay, this is very important. I'll just write the clamper circuit, that's all. So when you use this particular clamper circuit, what happens? Ultimately, whatever waveform, so depending upon the reference value here, V reference voltage, what you are setting in this particular potentiometer, so that much voltage, it will come down. Okay, it will it shifts entire waveform to this particular value. So now 5 volts. If 2.5 volts, 0 to 5 volts is the peak value. So if you set 2.5 volts, then if you shift 2.5 volts as a reference, then what happens? That waveform will, you know, will look like this. You understood? 2.5 volts, it will shift down. So when it shifts to 2.5 volts down, then that 7F will become 0, 0. Okay. Since it is analog signal, so it just shifts down. So this is basically negative clamping. Okay, negative clamping. Now, so this is how, you know, you see, if I want to generate a proper sine wave, okay, so now this procedure I have to use. What is the procedure? I need to have a microcontroller connected to DAC, okay, and that is in turn connected to negative clamper, okay, so that is one thing. And I should have a lookup table, so manually I have to calculate and feed this particular lookup table in the microcontroller memory. Okay, so I just showed one example how you can calculate the lookup table, and using this lookup table you will always get the positively clamped signal, and using negative clamper you are bringing that particular waveform down. Okay, so this is how you can generate the sine wave. So in case if you want to control the magnitude, okay, you can have some, you know, variables. Okay, so you can have some variables as a multiplication factor. Okay, as a multiplication factor, okay, so to these lookup table values, okay, you can have some multiplication factor for this lookup table values, so that, you know, what happens, that entire values analog quantity whatever you are generating, that compresses or decompresses. So that kind of, you know, things you can create using this. So to adjust the frequency, okay, so to adjust the frequency, what you can do, you can multiply some factor. Okay, so you can multiply some factor with the time space itself. Okay, so to for a different time space, you know, you can create different magnitude. In that way you can do so, that is also possible. Okay, so now in that way you can generate different frequency sinusoidal signal. Okay, so amplitude also you can vary, frequency also you can vary. So if you don't want this lookup table method, okay, so even you have some kind of, you know, time series method, okay, so you can convert the sine function to the infinite series or finite series and approximated series, and that you can use that series as a function and implement that particular function in a microcontroller, and then that will become completely variable magnitude and variable frequency lookup table. Okay, so in that way you can generate any waveform, okay, a sine wave with any frequency and magnitude. Okay, yeah, trigonometry, Ryan, trigonometry, yeah, manual. So there is no trigonometry, manually we have to create that particular lookup table. Manually we have to feed. Otherwise, it is possible to create the you might have studied, right, the sine series. So if you see this particular sine series, here you can see this function is there. So using this particular function, you can definitely, you can create a sine series. So you can go up to some order, and you can x is basically time, and you can implement this, at least now you can easily implement this particular function in microcontroller. It is easy. Okay, so you can implement cos sine. So it is, that's why I said you can have a lookup table, or you can implement this particular sine series or cos series. Okay, so you have multiplication, division, addition, subtraction, everything is there. So using that, you can write the program to find the sine of any value, and you can make it completely variable. So that is also possible. E6. So you converted and you gave. Everybody understood how to generate the sine wave. Any questions you have with respect to this sine wave generation? Okay. Yeah. So now, now the thing is, now if I ask the question like, how to generate triangular waveform? Okay. So I think you should be in a position to do same logic goes there also. If I want to generate a triangular waveform, again the same thing. Okay, so for each x, what is the magnitude? You can create a lookup table. Okay, so for each x, what is the magnitude value? So so for this waveform, if you want to create a triangular waveform, and you will work like this. Okay, so it starts from 7f. Okay, it goes like this, and it comes to zero like this. So this is basically one waveform, and after clamping, negative clamping, so you will bring the waveform down. Then what happens? So your waveform will look like this. Okay, so what you have to do, so you can have, so now here, it's not a sine function directly, y is equal to mx. You can use this equation. So but the thing is, you have 1 2 3 pieces of code. Okay, so 3 pieces of code you have, so that will basically repeat. So for these 3 pieces, you need to write a program, or you can have a lookup table. So in that way, you can control the frequency and amplitude. So if you can use this particular function, it is easy to make. Got it? How to generate the triangular waveform? Same logic. There is no change. Everything will be same. You can generate the triangular waveform. Fine. It's not only that. Okay, so some applications may demand some specific kind of waveform. Okay, so if I want like this, you may be knowing in signal processing. Okay, I may want this kind of waveform. You see, like this, anything is fine. Okay, so if you want to generate some custom waveforms, okay, so you can also generate. Okay, you can also generate using this particular method. Okay, so in that sense, any waveform you can generate, at least but the only thing is the clamping, just remember, because microcontroller DAC output is not always have negative value. It will swing from zero to the maximum value, because your input is varying from zero to FF. So logically, you have to fit these values in between that particular bound, and you have to clamp down to get your actual waveform. Fine. So any questions you have, you can ask. Otherwise, we can stop a session. Right. You understood? Everybody understood the generation of sine wave, any wave, sinusoidal waveforms, triangular waveform. I mean, this square wave and rectangular waveform is very simple. And in case if you want to control the magnitude of the step function, okay, then this logic you have to use. If you don't want to control the magnitude of that step signal, then you no need to do anything. Fine. Directly you can give the digital input on off kind of thing. So that is very simple. Delay program, control the frequency. Okay, so any questions on the waveform generation? Program, microcontroller program is very simple, nothing great about that. It just points to external memory. It takes one by one values and it will output in P0. Correct? It takes the values from one by one from the external memory and it put it in the P0 port, and that sinusoidal waveform will come at the output terminal of your module. Correct? Program is very simple, but to get that one, lot of these things you have to understand. Fine. Any questions? Any questions? Please do ask.
No, sir. Understood, sir.
Yeah. So thank you then. Okay. Happy weekend. Okay. So I am just closing the session. Fine. Thank you all.
Thank you, sir.